Hey, what's going on, True Blazer fans? It's Tori back with another game recap. Now, I hope you guys had a wonderful Christmas. I know I did, other than that nightcap on ESPN, that tragic Blazers game. I'm sure that put a little bit of a damper in your day too as well. If not, then you're lucky, because it definitely bummed me out. I was really looking forward to this game, a Christmas Day matchup, finally. And then our team doesn't even show up. Just a little bit of warning, this might be one of my most negative game recaps ever. Possibly my most negative game recap because I was very, very frustrated with a lot of things that happened last night and then the days leading up to it. A lot of these aren't even takeaways from the game. A lot of these have to do with the mental makeup of this team right now. You got Evan Turner talking about that Dallas game, saying thank God we won or else the fan base would have freaked out again. As if the fan base isn't justified in getting frustrated over the inconsistencies of this team. Honestly, I think the fan base on average is more frustrated than the players on this team with their inconsistency. If you don't see the problem in that, then I don't know what to tell you. This team sometimes can't seem to be bothered to give a consistent effort. And they don't seem mad in post-game comments, you know. Yeah, it's nice to keep it even-keeled, but you don't even sense really any frustration at all when they get absolutely blown out, which has happened multiple times this year. There have been way too many games where we're not even competitive, but I have a feeling that this team is like, okay, we've shown here and there that we can be a good team, we don't need to worry about when we play bad. That's the vibe I get from this team, and they'd probably tell you differently, but this team doesn't seem concerned with the issues going on right now. And yeah, they might turn it on again, and then the season say, oh yeah, it would have been nice to have a more consistent effort at the start of the season. But this happened the last 3 years, and for some reason this team doesn't learn from it. Now let's fast forward to the halftime interview with one of the assistant coaches coming out of the locker room. Given up 59 first half points, and that was after the Utah Jazz missed 10 free throws. We were lucky not to give up 66-67 points in that first half. In that halftime interview, the assistant coach said something like, oh, the defense has been pretty good for the most part. Now that just boggles my mind. How you can give up 59 points to a slow-paced team that's a defensive-minded team, and they miss 10 free throws, and you can say the defense was pretty good. That just shows a disconnect with reality from the coaching staff right there. But if you think I'm frustrated now, let's just talk about some of the effort that the Blazers did during this game. Now I will show a couple clips here of just absolutely terrible effort, and it's Christmas Day. A lot of people just got done having dinner with their families or sitting down hoping to cap off a wonderful Christmas Day with a Blazers win, and at least if they lose, you know, at least they tried, right? But there were so many plays where the Portland Trail Blazers gave absolutely zero effort, and it got me more frustrated and mad than I've gotten this entire season. If you can't show up and give effort on Christmas Day, then you shouldn't be wearing a Blazer uniform. Because, Lord knows, me being as out of shape as I am, I would give 100% effort. I would dive on the floor. I would give whatever I had to try and get the Blazers a win. Honestly, I think more than half of the players on this team would not do the same, and it's frustrating. Lack of focus has been something that's plagued us this season. You have that, lack of effort, lack of consistency. There just seems to be a problem with this team in terms of mentality. Maybe it starts at the top with coaching, maybe Damian isn't as good of a leader as we think he is, maybe the role players just don't have it mentally, and you know, you got guys like Harkless who are very inconsistent, who sometimes are terrific assets and sometimes they don't show up at all. I don't know what the problem is, but there's a problem. And you would expect to hear about this problem from the media surrounding the Blazers, but Jason Quick has been stuck behind a paywall, and he was pretty censored last year at NBC Sports Northwest. And from what I've heard from people that know Olshey and know the situation around the team, Olshey does a pretty good job of stifling reporters. And now I'm not saying that there's for sure something that these guys aren't reporting on that they know or that it's been that way in the past, but it would not surprise me at all. I mean, in the past you would have Quick, and even though I can't stand him, you'd have Canzano blaring all sorts of locker room mishap, even the most minor of incidences. And now with the team seemingly falling apart mentally, there's absolutely nothing. And I know what you might say, oh, they've won 4 out of their last 6 games, the only games they've lost to is the Utah Jazz, that's a bad matchup. This team is talented. They're talented enough to make up for their deficiencies. That doesn't mean they're not there, and their mentality right now is a huge deficiency. I think Stotts is partly to blame because he doesn't hold players accountable enough. You have CJ McCollum going iso ball like crazy, getting under 3 assists per game, even though he said he was going to pass more this year and shooting a ton of contested shots. I've never seen Stotts get on him or bench him for any of that. Freedom has allowed some lesser known role players to kind of break out, play with more confidence, but we have such an utter lack of accountability that it's a problem. But back to the media, you don't have any reports of anything going on behind the scenes, not even speculation. Another thing that I think might factor into this trend of stifling the media is replacing talking ball with Blazers outsiders. Now, talking ball was more of an opinionated, analytical type of breakdown on Blazer basketball. They'd break down where the Blazers are struggling. You'd have guys like Jason Quick, Orlando Williams, guys like that would speculate as to the problems with the team's mental makeup. You know, if the team doesn't seem fully bought in, they would say so. You don't have that same level of media with the Blazers outsiders. And that's not a dig at Blazers outsiders, because I'm sure somebody like Dan Morang, just based off reading his stuff at Blazers Edge, I'm sure he would like to break down more sets and more issues going on with the Portland Trail Blazers. But the network, for whatever reason, doesn't want to do that. And it makes you wonder, is this another domino in the trend of Neil Olshey stifling the media? This is why I love what I get to do here on True Blazer Fan, and why I hope this media source continues to grow, because I think this is a true alternative to what's happening in mainstream media. So I'm trying to fill that void of giving you guys better analysis than you have available to you, as well as calling the team out when it needs to be called out. As far as takeaways from the actual game, things that happened on the court, it's the same problems. Stagnant offense, perimeter-based movement with no designed cuts to the rim. Whenever we did freelance and cut to the hoop, we had pretty good results. But it was too far and few between. The ball didn't move, it was stagnant, we didn't run in transition at all. Our pick and roll coverage got obliterated by a Rudy Gobert, Ricky Rubio pick and roll, making that big man sag back and have to choose between defending the lob and defending the layup is not a recipe for success, and our help side defense isn't rotating enough to make that job any easier on that big man, so that's why we get hurt there. It's the same problems I've always talked about, and in the future, I will try and actually break down more footage. I'll line up some footage so you guys can see what I'm talking about, so hopefully I can paint a clearer picture for you guys, but this video I just had to get a few of these things off my chest. One final thing to get off my chest that is happening on the court, and I've talked a little bit about it already, but CJ McCollum is absolutely killing the Portland Trailblazers. What does he do well? He shoots jump shots well, but right now he's not shooting the three ball well. So he's shooting the most inefficient shot in basketball at an elite clip. His mid-range shots are falling, but that's literally the only thing that he does well. Does he rebound? No. Does he pass the ball? No. Does he defend? Big fat no. Does he score well at the rim? Not really. Does he get to the line? No, he gets around 3 free throw attempts a game. And right now, he's not shooting the three ball well. So all he's doing right now is shooting mid-range jumpers well. But that's inconsistent too, because last night that wasn't falling. So he's hurting the team in every single area. I love CJ. I wish that he could improve upon his deficiencies, but he's talked about becoming a better passer, and he's only regressed. So I'm getting closer to the we need to shop CJ bandwagon. We need to see what type of value we could get for him. Sadly, I don't think Olshey would even consider trading him because that was his draft pick. That's his guy. He thinks that CJ McCollum is an elite player. He thinks he's an elite scorer, even though he's only had one season with a true shooting percentage that was above average. So I feel like hopping on that bandwagon would only drive me crazy, because CJ McCollum isn't getting traded. I'd love if we could just make an impactful trade in general. So anyway, my ranting is over. We're jumping into the recap for the next two games against the Golden State Warriors. Hopefully we win one of them. There's really nothing much to go over. I think we will probably lose both of these games. I'll be pleasantly surprised if we win one. You guys know what Golden State can do. You guys know their weapons. You guys know where we've been struggling. So there's really nothing much to preview there. So I'm just going to wrap up this video before we run out of time. This has been Tori. I hope you guys have a great rest of your year. Peace out. Go Blazers.